What is up, it's Mikey. Are you brand new to Call of Duty World War II? Well, this is for you if you're just getting started, if you're brand new. Well, let's get into it. So the first thing is the divisions. When you sign in, they make it seem like a big deal. It really isn't. You can change this at any time, okay? It's not like a faction or a clan or something that you're bound to. It can change at any moment. So what is the big deal with the divisions? So first up, the infantry division here. We have infantry, which is focused around the rifles, or modern day, they're called assault rifles. Pretty much mid to long range, well, really mid range in this game. We have the airborne division, which is based around small machine guns, submachine guns, what have you. Armored is big guns, LMGs, light machine guns. At this time, they move slow, they're big and clunky. And then we have mountain, which is for snipers, silent. You see your character has that ghillie suit on. And then the expeditionary, which is focused around shotguns. If we go through these, we notice they all have special abilities. Right now, let's focus on infantry. And you see the first ability is a rifle bayonet. And you can choose that. Now, you're wondering, well, what happens if I want to pick a submachine gun? Or what happens if I want to pick an LMG or a sniper or a shotgun? You're more than welcome to do that, but you're going to lose out on some benefits, okay? So, going back to infantry, what's the first benefit you get? A rifle bayonet. It's a long pointy thing at the tip of your rifle. Well, if you decide to put on a shotgun, you're not going to get a bayonet now, are you? There are no bayonet attachments on the shotgun. So you're going to lose that particular perk. With that said though, one of the abilities of infantry is to gain an additional primary attachment. So if you wanted to, you can have a shotgun with three attachments, which you normally can't do with all the other classes. Now you notice there is that little white warning symbol up there. It doesn't tell you what it is. It should. Basically, it's telling you that you are using a weapon that is not optimized for your division. Okay, so again, infantry is based around rifles. You're more than welcome to use any weapon you like, but you're not going to benefit from that. So moving on, we have the airborne division. Do you like to rush and run and gun like a chicken with the head cut off? Well, this may be for you. It's definitely for me. You should probably have some experience with Call of Duty, but the main thing is that it allows you to run around with the suppressor. It's a very fun class, I think. You can sprint for longer distances, you can climb over obstacles faster, increased sprint speed. So it can be a very fun class, but if you don't have map awareness, maybe it may not be for you, but it's definitely very fun. And by the way, you gain all these abilities by ranking up that division. And again, you're more than welcome to mix and match. You know, if you want to run around with the sniper, you can do that. And there's a lot of people that do that. So don't let this game put in your head you can't mix and match. You're just going to lose that suppressor, okay? If you want to go with infantry and put on a submachine gun, you will no longer be able to use a suppressor. The suppressor, by the way, is done in game. It's not an attachment that you put on right here in the customization screen. You do that in game by hitting left on the D-pad if you're on console. Moving right along to the next division, we have armored, and that's for LMGs. Personally, it's not for me at this time, but you get an LMG bipod that gives you more stability. You're immune to shell shock, you know, explosions, things like that. Tacticals cannot stun you. You'll take less fire damage, and eventually you will take less explosive damage. So this is for a class, for someone that's just gonna be, you know, on a flag, capping a point. You got grenades and flashes and stuns and all kinds of stuff coming at you. And that's what armored is for. You got armored. It's pretty cut and dry there. Do you want to be an elite sniper? Well, mountain can be for you. You get sniper sharpshooter. You get improved aim, you know, less sway, looking down the scopes. You're invisible to enemy recon, so you don't pop up on that UAV, or recon as it's called now. You're hidden to player controlled streaks, and you move silently. What that means is your footsteps are dead silence, but the footsteps in this game are pretty quiet as is, so it's really not that big of a deal. But it's for someone who truly wants to move around the map and not be spotted. But if you look at one of my older videos, I do use the airborne class with the submachine gun with the silencer, and I find that if I'm constantly moving, running, and gunning, by the time I pop up on the blip, on the UAV, on the minimap, I'm not even there anymore. Okay, but if you're just beginning, then maybe running and gunning isn't for you and you're just gonna piss off your teammates. But hey, it's just a beta. Do whatever you want. Get to know the map. And in fact, running around like a chicken with your head cut off, that's one of the best ways to get to know the map in the first place. All right, and finally we have the expeditionary. That's the one for the shotgun, guys. And basically what it does is it allows some of your bullets to shoot out fire. They're incendiary and they burn people and they get them very upset. Shotguns are okay in this game. Think of the shotgun as an extended melee, as a sword. Sometimes it will be a one-shot kill, other times it'll take two shots. Alright, but the cool thing about being an expeditionary, you get to select a piece of tactical and lethal. Alright, so what is that? Well, your lethal could be a good old-fashioned frag grenade, a sticky bomb, or a claymore. But you can see the names are different, but they do the same thing. An S-mine is a thing that sits in the ground. People walk by, they get blown up. Sticky can stick to people, plants, wherever it lands, it sticks to. In a good old frag grenade, you're used to that in all sorts of games. The tacticals are a British tactical concussion. It basically stuns people. It's a big stun. We have smoke, which is very, very useful, almost a must for objective and war based modes. And then you have a good old gas grenade, which sort of works as suppressing people. If you don't want them to come through an alleyway or a corridor, you can throw some gas, and if they don't have a counter to that, they're gonna hold back. All right, guys, so that is all the divisions. Definitely play with them, have some fun, mix and match. And next we're gonna talk about the next big thing, which is basic training. It's sort of like a perk, and I'll go over these quick with you. Getting into the basic training, which is sort of like perks from older Call of Duties, we have launched, which lets you take a launcher as a secondary. You know, it is a good way to take down UAVs. By the way, if you want to do that, I'm sorry, they're called recons now. If you want to do that, all you do is aim ahead of the aircraft and it'll probably hit it. It's got a really big splash radius, very easy to take out. But even weapons, you know, your LMG, an assault rifle, an SMG even will take down a recon plane. Look out, it is very, very useful, and it may need a nerf or something soon. But basically, enemy targets appear from further away. Your minimap gets increased coverage, and basically their red gamer tags pop up. Insanely easy, even if you're not aiming down the sights. And I'm thinking that may be, taken down quite a notch, because the distance that you can see people is pretty crazy. So in that sense, it is a very useful for you snipers and assault rifles and even SMG people. It really just helps you find people. So lookout can be very good. Forage is sort of like a scavenger perk. Resupply bullets from killed enemies, and you can swap weapons faster. We have hustle, which lets you reload faster, and you can reload while sprinting. It goes great with the airborne class, because as you're running to your next position, you can reload. It's great. You have lower downtime. One of my favorites. We have rifleman. You see, I do not have it unlocked because it lets you take two primary weapons. But hey, why not just pick up a weapon off the floor. But if you really, really want to have two specific weapons, then hey, go for it. But I don't recommend wasting a token on it. We have Duelist, take two attachments on a secondary weapon. The secondaries really aren't that great, so that's why I'm not bothering with that. We have Gunslinger. You can fire guns while sprinting and diving, and this could be very good for SMG people, shotguns, where aiming down your sights after sprinting, it is very slow. At least right now in this iteration, it's very slow. People have complained about it. This may be fixed, but in the meantime, Gunslinger allows you just to shoot your gun while you're running, whereas the other person, they need to pull up their weapon. They can still hip fire, but not as fast as you can with Gunslinger, so something to keep in mind. Espionage. Enemy score streaks and enemies you damage appear on the minimap, and it appears quite a while, and I believe your teammates get to see that because you get assist points. Basically, if you shoot someone, they turn into a red dot on the minimap that everyone gets to see. As far as I know right now, it is a beta. Who knows? It may change. But at the very least, it appears for you. You can even go to your minimap if you really wanted to, like the big map, the overview, and you could see them. All right? And not to mention enemy score streaks. They appear on the minimap also. Requisitions. Do you want to have fun and try out every single streak, but you can't maintain a 2-kill streak? Requisitions, basically, score streaks do not reset on death, but it does cost more and you can only earn your streak once. So if you're an objective player, you're constantly running to the flag or you're constantly dying, this may be fun for you because that way you can almost guaranteed, depending on how long the match is and depending on how many kills you get, you will have a guaranteed way to use whatever score streaks you want, and I will get into those in just a moment. So that's very fun if you're an objective guy or you're brand new to the game and you just can't get a 10 kill streak. This will solve it. Up next is Bang. Take an extra tactical grenade, and along with that you get a frag. Okay, so there's a little slight confusion with that, but here you go. You get to have almost any tactical. You cannot have two smokes. You cannot do that because they don't want you smoking out the entire map. And you get to have a frag. You do not get to choose which one. It's always going to be a frag. Okay, if you choose mountain or any other class, it's going to be one. Okay, but if you pick expeditionary, you get two frags. That's a lot of firepower right there, so that could be pretty fun. Okay, so we have some that I haven't really messed with. We have energetic, sprint again sooner with no damage from falling. That didn't seem appealing to me because I just never saw the need to jump off a cliff. Not yet anyways, but there you go. It's very interesting. Maybe something for trick shotters who want to jump off high places. And we have ordnance, very interesting, cheaper score streaks and the ability to reroll your own care packs. So if you can maintain a streak, it makes it so that way you can get your UAVs a little bit quicker, care packages quicker, and you can reroll it to change it to something else. So it's sort of like a hard line from older games, but if you're brand spanking new, this may not be a good option for you because you do still need to maintain the streak. But you know, again, if you're brand new, if you're really not that great at Call of Duty, I'm probably going to recommend requisitions if you want to try out the kill streaks. Well, what are the kill streaks? The score streaks? Let's get into that. So here they are. There's a few of them. We have the Molotov cocktails. You get one of them. And basically, it's sort of like a super grenade with a big splash damage. Really good for suppressing enemies if you don't want them coming down on place. If you hear your flag being captured, toss a Molotov on them. And a fun little fact, if you're holding onto the Molotov, you can one punch people. Yeah, at least for right now. We have the recon aircraft. Everyone shows up as a blip. You have the care pack, which could be a random thing. And if you have that one perk that we were just talking about, ordnance, then you can re-roll that care package and it'll turn to something else. And you can see Ordnance knocks it down from 5.7 kills to 4.5 kills. Fighter pilot, it's okay. Basically, you get the pilot and you get one bombing run or one gunning run. It's okay. Expect one kill from it. It's all right. Maybe the guns need to be buffed a little bit. We get the glide bomb, which you get to control the bomb, moving it with the right stick and pop it on someone's head. You have the mortar strike. You get to call in three areas where the bombs will come flying in. It's great for a domination mode. You know, you want to keep people who are capping a flag. Artillery, mark an area in the map and all kinds of bombs come down and blow them up. And then you have the paratroopers that brings down four little autonomous guys. And this will sometimes give you 3 to 5 kills, at least right now in the beta. So it's okay. It may need a buff of some kind. Moving on to the dossier, that is where you change your face, calling card, emblem. And yeah, there's only a few faces right now, but yes, it is possible to be a black female Nazi. Calling cards, there's not too many to choose from. Same goes for emblems. And then you could change your clan tag to whatever. If you're a brand spanking new, you probably want to start out with either TDM, which is just killing people. And another fun mode to start out with is war. War is very fun. The enemies will always come from the front, like 95% of the time. So you know where they'll be at. And there's no kill streaks. No kill streaks and no death meter. So you can die as much as you want. It don't matter. The object of the game is to push forward. War is a great mode to just have fun, try the different weapons. I highly, highly recommend have a smoke bomb on hand when it comes to the bridge area, because you will need to either get cover or give cover to your teammates so that way they can help build the bridge. So play war, it's a lot of fun. You play the objective and don't worry about your death count. So we have social over here. This is where your party is. And those are really the basics. If you want more Call of Duty tips, hit subscribe. Check me out. I'll be posting this game like crazy once it's out. Please give the video a thumbs up. And in case you missed it, on the top there, we have my latest video. And on the bottom, the top clips of the week. It's Call of Duty. And we're probably going to have some World War II clips. Send them in, guys.